Welcome to Twilio Update, the bi-weekly show that takes you behind the scenes of the latest developments in the Twilio ecosystem. I'm your host, Alex Goldman. First up, we'll cover the latest from the Twilio changelog, things like enhanced messaging capabilities, new voice intelligence features, and you'll hear what's up with WhatsApp. Then, we'll take an in-depth look at Twilio's launches in conversational AI and see how you can use them to build smarter voice apps with just a few lines of code. And as always, we'll keep you in the loop on all the upcoming Twilio events, live streams, and community happenings. So stick around. This is the one-stop shop for staying ahead of the Twilio curve. And to those listening to me in 2x speed, you scare me, but I respect you. Let's talk updates to the changelog. First, RCS Public Beta. Twilio does so much these days, but we got our start as the texting company. So I'm excited to kick this off by giving you an update on the rollout of RCS. You know, the only thing better than reliable notifications, exciting notifications, messages with buttons or interactive elements or pictures. Well, Twilio has launched another feature for RCS into public beta, messaging with rich content. RCS is an upgraded version of SMS and MMS created by Google to support media-rich messages. If you're an Apple user, this was just rolled out in a recent iOS update, which is why you'll see that the green bubble experience has gotten a little bit better. For all you green bubble friends, I'm sorry for the years of bullying. I promise to do better. Twilio has added the ability to send RCS messages through our content template builder, which is a way to add things like rich cards, media, and carousels into your RCS messages. And again, because we're omnichannel, we'll still fall back to SMS or MMS and let you define what that would look like if the customer does not have RCS enabled. If you want to use RCS, you do need to sign up on the Twilio RCS page to get it added to your account. We'll have more updates and a deeper dive into RCS in a future episode. Moving from one awesome messaging channel to another, we're making it even easier to use WhatsApp messaging through Twilio with our WhatsApp self-signup to all direct customers. Adding WhatsApp to the mix of your communication channels is just another way to make your customer support notifications more seamless. There's a certain omnichannelness to it. Continuing on the WhatsApp train, let's talk about everyone's favorite pastime, waiting for confirmation codes. Yes. Verify will now always fall back from WhatsApp to SMS to ensure that your OTP or one-time passwords get delivered. Starting on March 1st, if a customer is not accessible from WhatsApp due to an outage, a service issue, or even an outage during a service issue, it will automatically fall back to SMS. You can always opt out of this, and if a fallback occurs, the billing will be as if you had sent an SMS OTP request in the first place. But this is just another great example of how we're making sure that your customers are getting the info that they need. On to our final update. Twilio can provide live transcriptions of voice calls through voice intelligence. Developers can now process speech in real time, enabling applications like AI summaries, customer service, legal documentation, or simply decoding what exactly happened on that 8 a.m. call. Now, here are some reasons this feature really stands out. Number one, it has persistent live transcripts. You can automatically store real-time transcriptions in Voice Intelligence's historical log for future analysis. Second, you can run post-call language operations. Once the call concludes, there are automated AI-powered insights and actions, like summarizing call topics or identifying next steps. And third is the seamless configuration. You can enable all of this by adding the intelligence service parameter to your transcription session via the TwiML transcription verb or the real-time transcription API. Taken together, this allows you to extract actionable insights at scale while ensuring seamless integrations with your existing workflows. With Twilio Voice Intelligence, every conversation becomes an opportunity for data-driven decision-making. To explore more about configuring real-time transcriptions or the capabilities of voice intelligence, check out our TwiML and API documentation. Now, we're going to move on to the main story, our runtime. And we're going to stay on the topic of voice AI because, ironically, people can't stop talking about it. Late last year, we announced the public beta of a new product called Conversation Relay. Conversation Relay is essentially a tool that makes it really, really easy to integrate AI into your voice applications. It uses just one line of Twilio markup language, or TwiML, to connect AI to conversations. So it makes it almost effortless to plug in voice AI into any application. Developers can use Twilio's built-in AI tools, or they can BYO LLM. You know, bring your own large language model. I'll let you all in on a little insight about why we named this product Conversation Relay, because it helps explain a bit about what it does. In its most basic form, this tool relays voice conversation into text. When someone on a phone is speaking, Twilio will in real time convert that speech to text and stream it to wherever you want. Then you stream back a text response and we take care of converting that into audio. It is taking out the need for you to manage the speech to text and text to speech pipelines. You can use this to plug into AI, as we have seen most of our early adopters do, or use it for any other system that has a text-based input and output. Then, to make using voice AI even easier, we're launching Voice for Twilio AI Assistants, a fully customizable framework for building AI agents that can handle phone calls in a human-like way. They've legitimately got more charisma than me over the phone. AI assistants work across multiple channels, SMS, WhatsApp, and now voice. That's right, Twilio AI assistants have achieved omnichannelness. Beyond being omnichannel, AI assistants has a bunch of awesome features. Customer memory. Twilio AI assistants is made customer aware by integrating with Twilio Segment. Assistants can access and store relevant customer data, enabling them to personalize interactions based on previous engagements and customer profiles. This also means that an assistant's understanding of the customer will evolve over time. Knowledge. AI assistants can pull data from unstructured data sources, such as knowledge bases, company policies, documentation, websites, and more. This enables them to pull relevant information during interactions, helping to answer customer questions with greater accuracy and context. And last, but certainly not least, tools. Tools in the Twilio AI Assistant framework are specialized APIs that enable your assistant to perform specific tasks, such as retrieving real-time data, processing orders, or executing complex operations. Tools function similar to webhooks. When a user makes a specific request, the assistant triggers the appropriate tool, which then performs an API call. For example, if you are an airline, you could tell it how to access your bag locator API to help a passenger find a lost bag. Lots of businesses want AI-powered customer service, but lack the resources to build it from scratch. This tool makes it plug and play, requiring only a few lines of code. I've gotten these virtual agents up in a matter of minutes. It's low latency with human-like interactions for great user experience. And you can really customize the experience for every single customer. If you already have an assistant and want to add voice, all you need is a little TwiML with your chosen voice, your assistant ID, and a welcome greeting, and the assistant takes it from there. You can get this up and running faster than you can say copy pasta. We've got some awesome blog posts and tons of great demos for Twilio AI assistants out there. One of my favorite demos was written by new Twilion Noah Mogul. He built a modular tool for deploying a Twilio AI assistant with pre-configured tools and knowledge bases. His project provides a structured way to create and configure an AI assistant for retail customer care. So then, what's the difference between Conversation Relay and AI assistants? Which one should you use? Think of Conversation Relay as the raw material for building AI-powered voice applications, while AI assistants provides a ready-made AI agent that you can start using right away. It's the difference between building a DeLorean time machine with an official Lego set versus building a Lego diorama of your favorite scene from Back to the Future 2. Either way, we're all nerds. So if you're an ISV, an independent software vendor, and you have other customers that you're helping to build AI applications, that would be a time when Conversation Relay would work. Or if you've already built out your own AI pipeline, maybe you want to use Conversation Relay. But for those of you looking for an easy-to-build AI agent that can personalize interactions, you might want to go with AI Assistants, because it has built-in intelligence, memory, and the ability to connect with customer data. It's low lift to implement, especially if you're already using Twilio and Twilio Segment. I am super excited that we finally have AI voice as a prime tool that can be used in the Twilio ecosystem. There's some really amazing tools out there, especially text-to-speech tools, that I've had the opportunity to play with. And while it was fun hacking on some code to get some silly voice demos working, I'm glad I don't have to share my poorly coded repos anymore. Twilio is making it easier for you to build out these applications and try it for yourself. This show is all about you, the builder. So each episode, I want to feature a builder so you can see the people behind the Twilio products or the companies building amazing products with Twilio. This week, we have an excerpt from my conversation with Brandon Hawkins, the product manager working on Conversation Relay and AI Assistants here at Twilio. Bianca recently asked Brandon about why voice is so important and how AI is renewing the excitement in voice.
Well, it's the oldest form of communication, right? It's the most human, the most natural. It's the first thing we learn when we grow up. It's the default, right? Mm-hmm. And I think being able to unlock that in a programmatic way, which Twilio does, obviously, that's the key. Right. Like it used to be, oh, all these things are in these weirdo telco systems and you can't see the data flowing through and it's hard to make it do what you want. And we sort of modernized that, but it is the primal channel, right? Everyone can resonate, mm-hmm. can connect with it. And it's how we communicate every day. It's, you know, what we've been breaking bread and talking over dinner tables for millennia. So it's just the default.
Yeah.
Right. I think we take it for granted, honestly.
But it's kind of interesting because it's like, if we think about, especially when you have these things that are so classic, there's a tendency to not want to change. So I think I'm kind of curious, like, how do you encourage innovation in some of these like legacy spaces, right? Whether that is voice, whether that is, you know, telecom, the space that we're in. But yeah, I'm just kind of curious from your lens, having to push products, especially I think like you've even had to do with like physical products or mm-hmm. like, how do you, yeah, pushing innovation in those spaces, just kind of curious, like what's been helpful for you?
I mean, the age old is, it's sort of like which are you glass half full, glass half empty? It's either cost savings and automation or better experience for your mm-hmm. end customers or better workflows. And so the best is when you combine both. That's how you kind of get people to care, right? Is like, as technology evolves, we find new ways of applying it. And voice is now the latest, right? With AI that people are turning their attention to and what we can do there, where you can give everybody an awesome experience, not just, hey, I hope they get a good agent today. If you call in a support mm-hmm. support number, or man, I hope even a human answers my call. Hope I can get through this phone tree, right? Like now everybody can get serviced, you know, by the best customer service rep, and they don't get tired and they don't get grumpy.
I appreciate Brandon's perspective on voice, and I'm excited about the future he envisions, mostly because I'm happy if I never have to press 2 for the front desk again. If you want to see the full interview, look for the A/B testing episode on Conversation Relay over on Twilio Dev's YouTube. Speaking of excitement about the future, we have our coming attractions, the preview section. Tomorrow, on February 26th at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern, is Twilio Segment's CDP Live event, Building a Customer-Centric Future, featuring Scott Brinker, the VP of Platform Ecosystem at HubSpot, and Rachel Warren, the Director of Owner Engagement at Pura. The Segment team puts on some awesome content. Definitely check that one out. And if you happen to be attending DevWorld in Amsterdam starting on February 27th, go say hi to some of my favorite Twilions who will be there. Marius Obert is going to be giving a talk about retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, in AI. You can also swing by the booth and talk to Nathaniel and Rishab, two of my favorite collaborators. I hear they're even going to be doing some interactive demos, and there's going to be a chance to win some Twilio swag. someone, please win me another Twilio shirt. I don't have enough already. And then in March, we will have two Twilio Transform Together events where we will be talking to the winners of the Twilio AI Startup Searchlight. The first one is on March 4th. The second one is March 20th. They're both at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern. Those are a really great opportunity to see how some of the most innovative companies are using AI and Twilio communication channels to create amazing experiences for their customers. I will also be hosting that along with Bianca. If you want to go back and check out some stuff that's already been put out through the month of February, we're launching our brand new Liftoff series. These videos are an awesome introduction to Twilio, focusing on messaging, voice, email, and user identity. How do I know they're awesome? Because I'm in them. You can find these in our docs or on the Twilio Devs YouTube. Last week, we had Twilio Builder Labs, The Builder Wears Twilio, hosted by Bianca and I. We dove into all the different ways that you can make the customer experience just better, especially with customer data and voice AI. Check out the recording on demand. You can watch it at 2x speed, like I know some of you are doing right now. You can also catch our past live streams on demand. This month's theme was all voice AI. Check out the stream to learn more about why we built these tools and for examples of builds with both Conversation Relay and AI assistants. And if that's not enough, we also just did a level up with video. Twilio built the video star. That's a great bit of content if you want to see how Twilio video works. So there you have it. Check out the Twilio blog post linked in comments for resources and to register for the upcoming events. Subscribe to the Twilio YouTube channel for the latest videos. And be sure to join the Twilio Discord community and let me know how I'm doing. We're trying to create a show for the Twilio Builder community. So if you have suggestions or tips for content you'd like us to cover, leave a message in the comments. I'm Alex Goldman. This was Twilio Update. I'll see you in 2 weeks.